A heroic rescue was caught on camera. A man is saved after going overboard one of the largest cruise ships in the world. We hear from the witnesses who helped him to safety. And this isn't the first time someone has fallen off a cruise ship. ABC's Cecilia Vega takes a closer look.
It was early in the morning in these choppy waters off the coast of Cozumel, Mexico.
I heard what I thought to be a really strange sounding bird, and a little speck in the water.
The speck turning out to be a 22-year-old man.
And I noticed that it was a young man screaming, "Help me," as loud as he could. "Somebody please help me."
Scott and Stephanie Campbell, passengers on a Disney ship called The Magic, spotted him.
I instantly got on the phone and called Zero.
Over the PA system on the ship, there was a call made, Mr. Mob, starboard side.
M-O-B, ship speak for man overboard. That man had somehow fallen into the Caribbean off another cruise ship sailing the same route earlier that morning.
And the crew took over from that point, brought the ship to a stop, circled around him. That's when I started videoing.
The rescue all caught on camera by David Hearn, who was also watching from the deck of the Magic.
It was very surreal. I never imagined in my lifetime that I would ever see anything like that.
These witnesses say people on board threw the man a life vest. The crew launched this lifeboat and raced to save him.
You know, once I saw him start swimming, I knew he was okay.
It made me feel very good as well to see that in an emergency, this is how quickly they responded.
According to the eyewitnesses, the entire rescue taking only 30 to 45 minutes.
They do these safety drills before we even leave port, and we're sitting there like, okay, let's get this over with. We're never gonna need any of this information. And to actually see it put to use was like, wow, okay. They're on their game.
Disney, the parent company of ABC News, did not issue a statement about its ship's rescue. In a statement, Royal Caribbean says, "We are grateful for the other ship's assistance." It's not known exactly how the man went overboard or where exactly he fell from, but the top deck of the Royal Caribbean's Oasis of the Seas is 21 stories tall. A fall like that would be longer than a drop from the top of Niagara Falls. The extent of the man's injuries still unknown, but according to eyewitnesses, he was able to swim and do more.
When they wheeled him off, he was in a sitting up position on the stretcher, and he was waving to everybody, and he was completely alert.
But no doubt, this experience must have been terrifying, something Sarah Kirby knows all too well.
I remember looking over the water, looking at the ship, and the next thing I knew, I was falling.
This is video of Kirby falling from a ship in 2012. She was on a 30th birthday cruise from Miami to Jamaica.
Everybody was drinking to excess, and I was enjoying it with everybody on the cruise. We decided to leave the bar, go back to our room. The next thing I remember is going out on the balcony.
Minutes later, in a moment recorded by a camera on the ship, she's plunging straight down toward the sea, first slamming into a lifeboat, then dropping another 5 stories into the water.
I was so scared, and I was gonna do everything in my power to survive.
She was badly hurt, broken bones in her face, fractured ribs, and a torn artery.
I remember being in a lot of pain. The water would crash into my mouth, and I would choke. I just prayed to God over and over, please don't let me die out here.
An hour and 31 minutes after she fell, she was spotted by the crew and rescued.
And we are now bringing her back on board the vessel.
According to the cruise industry, people falling overboard are rare.
It's actually one of the rarest events that happens on cruise ships. The rate of one overboard for every 1,650,000 passengers.
Still, more than you want. By one expert count, 22 people went overboard from cruise ships last year.
You don't get blown or swept off of a cruise ship. It does not happen. All of these incidents, unfortunately, are accompanied by some reckless or deliberate act.
Kirby still can't say exactly why she fell, but she is suing. Her lawyer, Michael Winkleman, says the ship should have saved her sooner.
The vessel should have been stopped. They should have been throwing life rings overboard so that she could have grabbed onto one, and they should have immediately gone and looked at the video.
In a statement to ABC News, Carnival Cruise Line said the suit claims are completely unsupported and contradicted by the evidence in the case. The case is still pending. So how do you make sure this doesn't happen to you? Is there one reason people fall over?
The easiest way that people fall over is that they're on the cruise ship to have a good time, not to pay attention to their surroundings.
Alcohol tend to play a role?
Alcohol does tend to play a large role in it. Also just, you know, the general horseplay of on vacation, want to have a good time.
Let's just hope you don't, but you fall in. What do you do?
If you land in the water, immediately afterwards, do what you can to try to control your breathing. You can actually drown within minutes or two just from panicking and not being able to get your breath. We suggest people move away from the vessel. It gives at least a better chance of somebody on board seeing you.
Regardless of how Kirby or this man ended up in the water, technology is being developed to make sure the crew is notified as soon as someone goes overboard.
Well, what we have here is a camera, a laser sensor, and we have software that is running on the screen behind us.
Dave Leone says his company, Radio Zealand, has a ship-shaped system. To see how it works,
gotta put this on?
Sure.
My colleague, Rena Ninen, took a plunge.
3, 2, 1!
By the time she hits the water, an alarm already sounds, and the system indicates exactly where she went overboard.
The vendors of these systems are very anxious to bring them to market. You can have birds set it off. You can have debris of any kind floating in the air set it off. These detection systems are not perfected.
Few ships have this system in place now. Some cruise lines say they have yet to see a system that meets their standards. In our case, our demonstration was on a boat, not a giant cruise ship, and on calm water. Tonight, one man happy to be back on dry land. A disastrous situation was averted by a stunning stroke of luck.
His location was, I mean, a miracle in itself. It's a miracle that he ended up where he did.
For Nightline, I'm Cecilia Vega in Los Angeles.